Hey, hi everybody in YouTube land and Tribe of the Horror Realm. Chris and Teresa are back. We're doing our movie poster collection. This is part four, the continuation. We're just going to move Demons 2 out of the way. You saw that one in the first video. And of course, not as cool as the one with Jamie Lee trying to keep the door closed, but this is a fog one sheet. And he thinks the way things are showing up, this might be taking the trip to Baltimore with us for the Monster Mania 20. Unfortunately, we decided we're going to probably bail on 19. It's a decent show, but the guests just don't jazz us as much, and we've got a show. There's that one in August, then the next one in September, and then we have another convention in October. It's just running a little much for us right now, so we're just going to take it easy in August and unfortunately skip out on the other one. There's the original one sheet, Phantasm 2. I don't know, at the last minute I decided not to get it signed by Angus Grimm, and I had the limited edition print done instead. I don't know, maybe I just wanted the original cast to sign a piece, and this one would be a little tougher to go around. I mean, I can probably get Reg and on there as well, but James LaGrosse might be a little tougher. So I like the artwork of the poster itself, so I'm just going to keep it as an unsigned. Aliens. You saw the earlier video of the Alien Resurrection, so we just still need an original Alien and an Alien 3 to make the collection complete. Not much you can say about that one. Really simple. The Trick or Treats. This one here, of course, something in the bag. If you're not sure what it is, it's an ear. Someone's head. Where have we seen this one before? This poster type art with a bag with a head in it and, well, Chopping Mall. And that one, I actually have a Chopping Mall that's coming to me. I just haven't got it yet. It's just sitting back waiting for me to have it sent. Just even sending one or two when I don't need to have them here. I usually like to wait until I get a few of them and have them all shipped out at one time. He knows you're alone. Of course, we know the answer that she did not check the children. This one, I tried to convince Teresa that we should have this framed and placed in the bathroom, but she thought that our guests would just not feel very comfortable having to look at that.
They'd be checking the toilet.
Put a tagline. They'll get you in the end. I dare them. Especially after burrito night, I dare them. And here's the stolen tagline. You can say to yourself, it's only a movie, but it won't help. And, of course, this film is pretty much a rip on Last House on the Left, except taking place in a train. Last Stop on the Night Train is released on DVD as The Night Train Murders. Just a simple ghost picture one, The Haunting of Julia. Was working off during the Peter Straub era in his ghost stories. And this one, she's a walking terror, still with fright, a trail of fear to fill the night. Jennifer makes Carrie look like an angel. Well, if it did its job, more people would know about Jennifer.
Yeah.
So we're going to have to go with didn't quite cut it. And it actually has Bert Convy in it. If anyone remembers, who the heck's Bert Convy? You probably saw him like every week on The Love Boat. This one, he was always like a guest on there.
Oh.
This one I can't believe. No one ever bid against me on this. I got this for less than a bunch of freaking Dunkin' Donut munchkins, you know, little donut holes. You're not familiar with it in this country. And if you're up in Canada, that would be a bunch of Timbits. But it's alive too. That's a hug. Another one that, who knows, might have to start getting that one signed as well. You know, Landis does the show, so does Norton. But the original American Werewolf in London movie poster, it's really nice shape. It's amazing what they get for these on eBay. And, hey, it's more Nature Gone Wild. The bee. I'm taking down planes left and right over there. But it's got the immortal John Saxon in there. It's pretty cool. Got someone else that's just got his face crawling with bees. At war with the human race. There's the original Amityville Horror one sheet. This dude is a little. There, next one up. Back to the city with the floating heads again. Amityville 2, The Possession, which is actually a good film on its own, right? And complete the hat trick, it's Amityville 3D. Maybe not, but it says it. And after that, this is an Exorcist ripoff, of course, Beyond the Door. Juliet Mills and Richard Johnson, Italian film here. This is another one that has been banned from being framed and put in the house because it just would creep Teresa out.
Did it?
Yeah, you don't like that face.
It's alright. I could deal with that.
Okay. Anybody after that? Damien, the Omen 2. And try to rifle through these really quickly. We've got a couple 2 minutes left. Eddie's Gonna Hunt in the Forest. And I'll tell you something. I could have been screwed royally on this. I had bid on this in an auction and an online auction, and I actually accidentally forgot to put a decimal point in. So my maximum bid was really over $1,000. So I don't know how that was going to work out, but it nevertheless, it certainly didn't reach that. And yes, we're not going through the old posters again. This is the second one. This is another Friday the 13th, Part 5, A New Beginning. I have two of them. So one of them will, if someone is into the poster thing and they want to do a trade for it, I'd be happy to. I'd love to get a different Friday the 13th one. Or whatever. You never know. But I do have two original Part 5 one sheets. This is from 1967, The Frozen Dead. I just loved the use of the text and how they did the font in this thing, and my cat's about to.
I knew that was coming.
Frozen for 20 years alive. They're frozen dead. Below that, back to Peter Straub. Ghost. Really boring poster. The Belgian poster I have is a lot cooler artwork, and in a future video I'm going to be going through some of my other, my foreign ones in a different size. Nightwing. So it's one of the early evil bat films before they had Blue Diamond Phillips and bats and all that stuff. But awesome. And this one, I got because it's got black cats on it, so my cat would really appreciate it. Stephen King's The Sleepwalkers. Or just Sleepwalkers, not The Sleepwalkers.
Nice. I think you'd be impressed.
The Spectre of Edgar Allan Poe. Don't know much about the movie, but it said Edgar Allan Poe, and both Teresa and I are total marks for the guy, so had to grab that one. I'm just going to kind of rifle through these real quick. It's over the 10-minute mark, but won't stay long on this one. This is another one of those possession films. This one was called The Night Child. Richard Johnson, Joanna Cassidy. Not much to say about that one. This was the Mutant Advanced One Sheet teaser, and Kindred. So that is so far what we've got for you for the horror one sheets. Up next will be the all of the categories one sheets. Then we're going to go into foreign ones and into French one sheets, the big suckers. So that's it. Thank you very much.